You know, I've heard "Fly Me to the Moon."
Yeah.
Too many times. Okay.
Okay.
So
we won't play it today.
No,
no, I get
my mission director. I bought some T-shirts the other day, and they are themed about Mars.
Uh-oh.
Curiosity and something else, but one of them in particular. Get your ass to Mars.
Yeah, I was looking at the logo now.
That I've seen before.
Somewhere.
Yeah. Would you look at those two moons?
Phobos,
Deimos. And Deimos.
Are they captured asteroids, do you think?
You know, at one time, we thought that they might have water on them. So, Phobos, fear. Deimos, the devil.
Uh-oh.
That's where the names came from. So if we can get ice out of ice, water, then we're talking about the tears coming from these moons.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Wasn't that clever?
It was.
Yeah. I don't think there's water there.
No?
No, I think they've been baked well, in the sun for them. Well, let's go and see anyway.
Well, let's go and see. How are we going to go? How are we going to get there?
I was going to have a return spacecraft system there before I sent people.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then when they got there, they could stay for a year and a half, and Mars and Earth are in the right place, so they'd come back. But when I was going to get people to the surface, I was going to use a cycling spaceship. And then I thought, well, Purdue has very nicely improved this cycler system, so it's a dual synodic period cycler.
Uh-oh.
Now, you don't know
over
what
my
that
head.
Means. Okay. The Earth catches up with Mars,
mm-hmm.
and as it's catching up, that's a good time to leave Earth and go to Mars, but it's also a good time to leave Mars and go to Earth.
Okay.
Now, Mars is going to make one revolution, Earth's going to make two, and a little bit more, because it's 26 months, mm-hmm. not 24. You know, the higher power could have made it 24, and it'd have been a lot easier to do some of these things. But you gotta take what you gotta take.
Mm-hmm.
And now, one synodic period is 26 months. That was my first Mars cycler. You wanna know how long ago that was?
I know
the
how long.
First.
I heard you lecture on that in 1986.
That's right, because it was 85 before the Challenger accident and before the study,
yep.
pioneering the space frontier.
Yep.
Because in a couple of early pages, he had cycling orbits,
mm-hmm.
delivering people from Earth to Mars.
The bridge between worlds.
That's what it was called. Before we get there, though, I asked myself, let's have two rockets and a lander on each one.
Mm-hmm.
See, we launch them separately, and then when we get in the right orbit around the Earth, we bolt them together so we can explosively separate.
Mm-hmm.
Now we gotta get three guys from this lander into that one. Something like that. But there may be other ways. See, that's a failure. Otherwise, we get two landers and only six people. And you put six people in each one. So I'm beginning to think, now two is better than one. Maybe three is even better than that.
Mm-hmm.
And if I don't have a failure, and I put six people in each one, each cycler is gonna deliver 18 people. Ask Boeing, ask Lockheed, ask those people how many people they're gonna get. Because they're going to bring them back.
Well, you bring up a great point. Who should be building these vehicles? Is this another government cost-plus program, or can this be done with competitive fixed-price private launchers?
It would be nice, wouldn't it? Generally speaking, the private sector can do something a little more efficiently than the government. Keep that in mind, because we may need to change things one of these days. But the private sector is looking for a profit. I don't know where you're going to make a profit. sending somebody to Mars. Mm-hmm. Now, sure, he's going to be a pioneer that's going to go down in history. He can write a book. He can give a speech. When you get it back here, it's a little old because it's taken a while. It's the speed of light to get back here. Private sector can do certain things, but they may need subsidy from the government. That gives them a distinct advantage. Space.com.